comes the fascinating world of trivia, where even a right answer can catch you in a trap. On Trivia Trap! The juniors are ready, the seniors are set to play, and here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob!
And hello, everybody. Welcome to Trivia Trap. We are going to have some fun today because this is the game for those of you who'd like to know a little bit about everything. Now, Trivia Trap is played by these two opposing teams. And one of our teams today will have the chance to climb our trivia ladder and maybe win a pot of gold of $10,000. It'll be fun. Over here, we've got our juniors. They're all under the age of 30, and their opponents are the seniors. And by Trivia Trap standards in our show, when you've hit your 30th birthday, well, you become a senior. And let's meet our two teams right now. We'll start with the seniors. Hi, Mary.
Hi, I'm Mary Mehta. I'm a sculptor, and I make a line of terracotta garden figures.
Oh, nice. Okay, Mary, nice to have you with us. Rollie?
Hi, Bob. I'm Rollie Friedman. I'm proud to be associated with the outstanding Los Angeles Zoo.
Well, all right, and I love your pandas.
Yeah,
Tony.
Right.
I'm Tony White, and I'm a restaurateur and caterer.
There they are, folks, our seniors. Now, you're going to have to put your trivia knowledge against our juniors, returning champions, and they're ready to play this game. Welcome back, Laura.
Hi, Bob. I'm Laura Farrell. I'm a law student at Pepperdine University.
Sure you are. Shari.
Hi, my name is Shari, and I'm a college pre-med student.
What a pretty lady. And Jim.
Hi, I'm Jim Burns. I'm a history major at UCLA.
The juniors on Trivia Talk. All right, let's play this game right now. We're going to start Trivia Trap, and we'll begin with our seniors, as we always do. Mary, you'll have to make the first choices. Up on our list of answers, you will find the top row consisting of these answers. Cough drop, a bent nail, a Roman coin, and a champagne cork. Top row. On the bottom now, Mary, take a look, if you would. Bob Barker, Ed McMahon, Bert Convy, and Hugh Downs. Mary, what you have to do is pick the top row or the bottom row to see which group of answers your team would like to play for.
I think I'll pick the bottom row.
With all of those guys down at the bottom, yeah. I will ask you this question. Good luck to you. Which of these TV personalities was once a professional baseball player? Now, one of those answers is the right answer. What you must do as a team is cut the wrong answers one by one, leaving the right answer remaining on the board. If your team can cut all three answers, you're going to win $300 for the question. Let me repeat the question. Which of these TV personalities was once a professional baseball player? Cut the wrong answers, Mary.
I'm going to cut Ed McMahon.
You don't think Ed McMahon was
don't
a baseball
think so.
Player?
No.
How about it? Can we cut Ed McMahon? It's a good choice. Rollie, again, you must find a wrong answer.
Oh, I'm going to cut Hugh Downs.
Let's see if we can do that.
Okay.
One. For Rollie, cut Hugh Downs.
Yay!
Oh. Audience was going, but you were correct in cutting Hugh Downs. That's obviously not the right answer. Tony, one of those two answers up there is the right answer. You must cut the last incorrect answer. If you do that, your team gets $300. So which will it be?
Well, I'm going to cut Bert Convy.
So you obviously think that Bob Barker is the correct answer. Let's see. Can we cut Bert Convy? No. Mary knew she was going, no. Yeah, it was Bert Convy. He was drafted right out of high school by the Philadelphia Phillies farm system. He was once a professional baseball player. Mr. Convy. All right. Anyway, you did cut two of the wrong answers, so we'll give you $50 for each one. So you start
That's
off, seniors, good. With $100. We'll pause for these words. We'll be right back to give our juniors a chance to play Trivia Trap right after this. To Trivia Trap. Well, our seniors, $100 on our baseball question. Now, remember, it's the team that makes it to $1,000 that wins the game and then goes on to play for a possible $10,000. Returning champions back for the third day are juniors, and they would love to get part of that $10,000 today. So, Laura, if the juniors are ready, let's play Trivia Trap. The top row, a cough drop, a bent nail, Roman coin, and champagne cork. On the bottom, juniors, new group for you. Here they are. The Fair Deal, the New Frontier, the Great Society, and the Square Deal. Top or bottom, Laura?
I think we'll go for the bottom row.
Here's your question. FDR described his administration as the New Deal. How was Lyndon Johnson's administration described? Got to cut the wrong answers, and Laura, you may begin.
Bob, I'd like to cut the new frontier.
Let's see if we can do it. The new frontier. Eliminate that answer, please. Excellent choice. One down, two more to go in order to get $300 for your team. Shari, cut a wrong answer.
I'd like to cut the square deal.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
Can we cut the square deal? Yes. Two answers remain. One more wrong answer and your team picks up $300, Jim. FDR described his administration as the New Deal. How was Lyndon Johnson's administration described? Find the last wrong answer, James.
It was not the fair deal. I'll cut the fair deal.
You want to cut the fair deal? So you obviously think the Great Society is the right answer. Let's see. How about it? The fair deal. Cut that one. Congratulations to you. I thought you picked the other categories, but you were right there. Yeah, the fair deal. Truman was the new frontier. No, excuse me, fair deal was Harry Truman. The new frontier was John Kennedy. The square deal was Teddy Roosevelt. And the Great Society, that's the one we were looking for, was Lyndon Johnson's. Very good indeed. $300 for you. $100 for the seniors. And Rollie, you get to pick the answers
okay.
This time. You know what's up on top begins with cough drop. Take a look now. Seniors, bottom row. Got some more for you. There they are. Barnum's Animals, Dogs and Cats, Zoo Snaps, and Grananimals. Rollie, top or bottom?
I'm taking the bottom.
Just sounds like fun.
Sounds like zoo.
Here's your question, seniors. We are all familiar with animal crackers, but what is Nabisco's official name for animal crackers that's printed on every box? Cut the wrong answers, Rollie, and begin right now.
I'm cutting Dogs and Cats.
Gonna cut Dogs and Cats?
Yes, I am.
How about it? Gonna cut Dogs and Cats? Good choice. Tony, you start nodding your head like you said, this is my kind of category. Okay, you got to find a wrong answer now.
Okay, I'm going to cut Granimals.
Cut Granimals? Audience agrees. Your team members agree. How about it? Can we cut Granimals? Sir. That's what I wear to bed at night. You think I'm kidding, don't you, Mary? Mary, we're all familiar with animal crackers. What is Nabisco's official name for animal crackers that's printed on every box? One of those answers is wrong. Find it, and your team gets
$300. I'd like to cut Zoo Snaps.
Whoa! For $300, can we cut Zoo Snaps? Yeah! Yes! So, seniors, good for you. Yeah, the string is on the box because in the early days, children hung them as Christmas tree ornaments. Isn't that a fun bit of trivia? I like things like that. All right, you have $400. Let's go back over to our juniors. They have $300. Shari, it's your turn to make the choices. Cough drops, a bent nail, a Roman coin, and a champagne cork. On the bottom, new group for you, juniors. Here they come. London, Tokyo, New York, or Paris? What will it be? The bottom row. Here's your question, juniors. By a factor of 2 to 1, where would you find the world's busiest airport for international flight?
I'm going to cut Paris.
How about it for the juniors? They think that's a wrong answer, and it is a wrong answer. Jim, cut the wrong answer.
I'm going to cut Tokyo.
Good luck to you, juniors. How about it? Can we cut Tokyo? Right on. Laura, by a factor of 2 to 1, where would you find the world's busiest airport for international flight? One of those answers is incorrect, one is correct. Find the last wrong answer for $300.
I'd like to cut New York.
So you think that London is the correct answer? Well, let's see. Audience, they're booing up there. We'll see. Cut New York for $300. Yeah! So there you have it. $600 for our juniors, $400 for our seniors. And remember, it's the team to get to $1,000 that wins the game and a chance to play for $10,000. In a moment, we'll start our $1,000 trivia race. And throughout the entire game, that one category was up there that had cough drop, a bent nail, a Roman coin, and a champagne cork. We'll play the game with you at home. It's kind of fun. Here's the question. What does opera singer Luciano Pavarotti always keep in his pocket when he sings? You know? Well, we'll be right back with the answer in our trivia race right after this. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. How'd you do with that question? That's a fun question, isn't it? What does opera singer Luciano Pavarotti always keep in his pocket when he sings? Do you know the answer? Well, if you said a bent nail, you were right about that. Our audience, they knew. Let's go back to our game now between our juniors and our seniors. Juniors, you have $600. Seniors have $400. Trying to get to the goal of $1,000. How do we get there? Fun. We'll play our exciting $1,000 trivia race. And let's do it right now. Trivia race till you get to $1,000. The first team to get there then has a shot at $10,000. Our juniors, you're out in front with $600. Seniors close behind. So that means the juniors will get to start first. And in our trivia race, every question is worth $100. But let me remind you, after the 10th question, the values then double. Each team will have three chances to come up with the correct answer. If all three of you miss, control then goes over to the other team. So juniors, you get to go first. Laura, pick a question, please. Will it be the Pope, royalty, or James Dean?
Let's start with the royalty.
For $100, you have $600. You're trying to get to $1,000. Here's your question. What European country is governed by the head of the House of Grimaldi? Shari.
I have no idea.
Jim.
Italy.
No, I'm sorry. Monaco. Monaco. Prince Rainier is the current head. You're frozen at $600. Control goes to the seniors. You have $400. You're trying to get to $1,000. Mary, pick a question.
I think I'll try Hollywood.
Hollywood. For $100, seniors. What Hollywood power owned a house nicknamed the House That Fear Built?
Frankenstein.
Rollie.
Hollywood power.
Tony.
Mayor?
No, I'm sorry. Incorrect. Gossip columnist. Hedda Hopper. Hedda Hopper.
Hedda Hopper.
That was the correct answer. You're frozen at $400. Control back to the juniors. Come on, juniors. Laura?
Courtesy.
For $100, you have six trying to get to $1,000. What famous figure once spread his cloak over a mud puddle for Queen Elizabeth? Shari.
The naked...
Jim.
Sir Walter Raleigh.
That's Sir Walter Raleigh. Yes. You rescued your team, James. You have 700. Laura, big deep breath and pick a question.
Reagan.
Here's the question now. For $100, Ronald Reagan's middle name starts with a W. What does the W stand for?
William.
No, incorrect. Shari.
Walter.
Incorrect again. Jim.
Winston.
No, I'm sorry. Wilson. Ronald Wilson Reagan, you're frozen at $700. Control back to the seniors. You got another chance. Mary, pick a question.
Cereal.
You have $400. Trying to get to $1,000. What breakfast cereal, in its ads, challenges consumers to pinch an inch?
Pinch an inch.
Time's up. Rollie.
Trix.
No, I'm sorry. Tony.
Special K.
Special K. You rescued your team. $500 for the seniors. Mary, pick
Tony,
a question.
Yes.
Hurry, please.
The Pope.
Here's your question. In what U.S. state did the Pope meet President Reagan in May of 1984?
I think it was Alaska.
Alaska is right, yes. Now you have $600. Rollie.
James Dean.
For $100. Trying to get to $1,000, who plays James Dean's father in the film Rebel Without a Cause?
Tom.
Time's up, Tony.
I don't know.
Mary?
Rock Hudds.
No, I'm sorry. Jim Backus. Backus was the right answer we were looking for. You're frozen at $600. Control back to the juniors. You have 700. You need 1,000 to win the game. Laura, pick a question.
Let's try quotes.
Quotes for $100. Who said, trust in God and keep your powder dry?
Marilyn Monroe?
No. Sorry.
Ronald Reagan.
No, I'm sorry again. Jim?
George Washington.
Incorrect. I'm sorry. Oliver Cromwell was the answer we were looking for. You're frozen at $700. You knew it, didn't you? Back to the seniors we go with $600. Trying to get to $1,000. Rollie, it's your turn to pick a question.
Should we go with monsters?
For $100. Okay. Seniors, in a 1979 movie, a monster threatened the crew of the spaceship Nostromo. What was the name of the movie? Tony.
It came from outer space.
Sorry, Mary.
Alien?
The alien is right. You rescued your team and tied the game at $700. All right, Rollie.
Fantastic. I have to do it again. All right. Love Boat.
Love Boat. For $100. Who sings the Love Boat theme song?
Oh, good heavens.
Tony. Time's up, Mary. Rescue your team.
Bing Crosby.
Sorry. Jack Jones. That was the answer we're looking for. All right, we're tied at $700. Each question is now worth $200. We've asked 10 questions. Each question now worth $200. Laura, pick the question.
I'm not doing very good at picking categories. Let's try cars.
Cars. For $200, what's the name of David Hasselhoff's wonder car on Knight Rider?
Kit.
Kit, that's right, yes. All right, juniors, one question away from winning this game and a chance to play for $10,000. Shari, you pick the question.
I'll pick languages.
Here it is. For the game and a chance to play for $10,000 in Europe, what language is the native tongue of more people than any other?
English.
Sorry, Jim.
French.
Sorry again, Laura.
Spanish?
No, I'm sorry. Russian. That was the answer we were looking for. German is number two. You're frozen at $900. Control back to the seniors. Rollie, pick a category.
Godiva.
Godiva for $200. Through what city did Lady Godiva ride?
Coventry.
Coventry is right, yes. You now have $900. Tony, pick a question.
Let's go with host.
Host. This is it. Get it right.
This is it.
You win the game and a chance to play for $10,000. Who was the host of TV's Newlywed Game?
Bobby Eubanks.
You're right! Our seniors are the champions. I didn't know that. Congratulations to you. We're sorry to say goodbye to you. You're now at $900 today. Laura, Shari, and Jim, you've been great champions. Thank you very much for playing Trivia Trap. We'll see you again. In a moment, we'll give our new champions, the seniors, a chance to play for $10,000. We'll be right back with that. We were sorry to say goodbye to our juniors. As a team, they won over $6,000. We have new champions, the seniors. Time to play for $10,000, seniors. So get over there and get in position, and let's see if you can't do it. As you know now, seniors, up until now, you've been playing as partners, but now you are on your own. Each of you will be trying to win money for yourself. Your positions have been determined by your success in the trivia race. Tony, that means you're in the number one position. You will then have the chance to pass or play. On the first set of answers, let's begin our climb up our trivia ladder, and here we go. The answers: Abe Lincoln, King Henry VIII, William Shakespeare, Thomas Edison. Tony, you have a choice to make. You want to play or pass them on to Mary?
I'm going to pass this one.
Pass to Mary. Mary, you have the same decision. You can play or pass them to Rollie.
I think I'll play.
You're going to play. Mary, the question is yours. If you give me the correct answer, you win $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000. Here is the question. Who was married to a lady named Anne Hathaway? I need the correct answer.
William Shakespeare.
William Shakespeare. For $1,000, a chance to play for $10,000. Was William Shakespeare married to Anne Hathaway? Yes! Congratulations, Mary.
Well, thank you.
You've just won $1,000, and better yet, you get a chance to play for $10,000. Let's go to the next level of our trivia ladder for Tony and Rollie. The answers: A1, A-N-A-2, Bubbles, Mr. Polka, or Wonderful. Tony, play or pass?
I'll take it.
You want it?
Sure.
Here's your question. What is the California license plate on Lawrence Welk's car? For $1,000 and a chance to play for $10.
I'm going to say Mr. Polka.
Your answer is Mr. Polka. Let's see. For a chance to play for $10,000, is that Lawrence Welk's license plate? Sorry. A one and a two. That was the license plate we were looking for. Tony, that means we're going to have to say goodbye to you for today. You'll be back to defend your trivia crown with your team tomorrow. So long, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
All right, Rollie.
Okay.
And now you must play. Here we go. Right to your level of the ladder. George S. Patton, George Armstrong Custer, Dwight D. Eisenhower, Ulysses S. Grant. Here's your question. Which U.S. Army officer was promoted to general at the young age of 23? Correct answer, please.
I'm going to go with Custer.
She says it's George Custer.
No.
For $1,000, a chance to play for $10, is it George Armstrong Custer?
Yeah!
Yes!
I knew it. I knew it. I knew it.
Congratulations, Mary and Rollie. You both have qualified to play for $10,000. And without any further ado, let's give you that opportunity right now. To the top we go of our trivia ladder with a pot of gold worth $10,000. And these answers, M&M's, Hershey Bar, Snickers, Reese's Pieces. The question, Mary and Rollie, here it is. What are the best-selling candies in America? Now, please raise the cover in front of you and record your choice. What are the best-selling candies in America? Lock in your answers, please. You've done it. Mary?
I give Hershey Bar.
You said Hershey Bar. Rollie, which answer did you say?
I picked my favorite. I said Snickers.
You said Snickers.
Hey!
This is for $10,000. Here we go. Mary, if the answer is Hershey Bar, you've won $10,000 by yourself. Is it Hershey Bar?
Oh.
No, I'm sorry, it was not Hershey Bar. All right, Rollie. If the correct answer is Snickers, Rollie, you will win $10,000 all by yourself. What are the best-selling candies in America? Is it Snickers? Yes, it is! Seniors to tell you about tomorrow's show in just a moment. Our seniors won over 13,000. We'll be back tomorrow. Hope you will be too. I'm Bob Eubanks. Bye-bye from Trivia Track.
Remember when Regis got jiggy with it? Eubanks was like totally radical, and contestants were far out. Take a trip back in time with the GSN Midnight Flashback. Rewind through three decades of classic game shows five nights a week. The GSN Midnight Flashback, Tuesday through Saturday starting at 12 midnight, only on GSN.